हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सेवेंथ इंग्लिश मीडियम, वी आर ऑन द चैप्टर नंबर 3, डेटा हैंडलिंग। इन द लास्ट सेशन वी लर्न अबाउट द सम एग्जांपल्स रिलेटेड टू मोड एंड द मीडियन। नाउ वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट some graphs. Actually, you already learn about that graphs. We first organize the data as a frequency table. But as we already know about it, that when this data is represented pictorially or graphically, it is very easy to understand and to make some decisions, some deductions from that data. Bar graph is one of the graph which is very useful to represent the data and to understand the data also. The bar graphs are useful to make deductions about the data. Means from the data you can deduct some result about the information. We can also get some informations based on these bar graphs. We know that bar graphs have different heights. Their width are same, but they have different heights. And that heights are according to the frequencies. So now, from the bar graph, if you want to find out the mode, it is very easy. You know how? What is mode? Mode is that observations which occurs more often. It means that the frequency of that observation will be highest frequency. And if that frequency is highest, the bar related to that observation will be the highest. It means that in a bar graph, if you see one of the bar that is the highest, longest bar, then you can say that that is the mode of the given data. So without any observation, directly you just see that which bar is the longest one, highest one, and the frequency related to that bar will give you the value of the mode of that particular data. So it is very, very useful to draw a bar graph from the given information. Now when we draw the bar graph, we have to use a proper scale. Without scale, we cannot draw proper graphs. Because sometimes the data is small, then we can take one unit as a one person or one whatever is that quantity given. But if the numbers are big, like in hundreds, then you have to choose a proper scale so that you can accommodate the highest frequency also. Because if the frequency is like more than 100, and if you take 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, one unit is equal to 2 length, then you won't be able to accommodate all the frequencies. And therefore, according to your page length of the graph and the highest frequency, you have to both take in your mind, and then you have to choose a scale like one unit length has 10 observations or 50 observations or 100 observations. It's on you, but you have to think that it should accommodate all the frequency, the highest frequency also. So It is not like you can take 10 or 100 only. You can take one unit, is equal to two observations also. If this is small, you can take one unit as one observation also. One unit as two observations also. One unit as five observations also. Or 10 observations. Or 50 observations. According to your data. That you have to choose properly. Then you will be able to draw the bar graphs very nicely. Then sometimes what happens? There are two data, two observations together. When we have to compare two collections of data together, for example, the teacher wants to check the performance of the student in two subjects like maths and science or English and SS. Then for each student we have to draw double bar graph. Similarly, a company maybe want to compare the profit of two consecutive years, or some others like selling of the books in 2 weeks, first week and second week. So in this situation, when we have to compare two sets of the data, two collections of the data together, then similar way, but for one we have to draw two bars. For each observations, we have to draw two bars together, joined with each other, which is known as double bar graph. You can see that here. Here in which it is the hours of sunshine in two cities, Margit and Aberdeen, during the different months from January to December. So here in this, they take January, March, February, March and up to December. And the temperature of, the hours of sunshine for the Aberdeen and Margit everywhere. So the two sets of data can be added, then it is the double bar graph will be very useful for this type of information. Now, we will start exercise number 3.3, in which the question 1 and question 2, they are very simple. You have to just watch the graph that is drawn in the book, and from the graph you have to give the answer. And they are very simple, so I left it for your homework, question 1 and question 2. So let's start with question number 3. Number of children in 6 different classes. 6 different classes are given below. What we have to do? Represent the data on bar graph. Represent the data on bar graph. Class that are 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, rather simply we will write down 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th. and the number of children in each class. In fifth there is 135, sixth 120, in seventh 95, in the eighth 100, ninth 90, and in tenth 80. Now before we start the bar graph, there is one question here, that how would you choose a scale? Now I can see that here the highest frequency is 135, and I have not a big board, so I am taking according to availability space on my board. But you can change that scale according to your graph page, because in your graph page there will be lots of boxes like that. If I will take that small boxes, you won't be able to understand the graph. And therefore I am taking scale as my convenient. I am taking here like 1 unit is equal to 20 children. So I can take 20 here, then 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, because highest is 135. But if in your graph page you can take 10, 20, 30, 40 also. You can take 10, 20, 30, 40, because your graph page will be bigger and your almost you will have say about 18 to 20 boxes. So easily you can choose that graph scale of one unit is equal to 10 children. But I am taking here scale 1. So scale will be 1 unit is equal to 20 children. But you can take, as I told you, 10. So here I will write down scale on y-axis. 1 unit is equal to 20 children. I took 20, but you can try by taking 10 children so that there will be enough space in your graph book. So now on the x-axis we took the classes 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th, and on the vertical y-axis we took the number of children and the scale 20, 40, 60, 80, 100 and so on. Now the 5th class has 135 children. So here we have to draw bar graph, so we will take both side equal spaces and we have to go up to 135. So now you can see that here it is 120, 140. So between them will be 130, and between 130 and 140 there will be 135. So here will be 135. So we have to draw the bar of that height of 135. So that is your 135. Then next, standard 6 has 120. You can see that 120 is here. So from these two lines you can have the bar graph which will be 120. You will draw according to the same width, but here it is not possible to draw properly because I don't have a graph page here. Then 7th had 95 children. So the standard 7th, 95 will be here, 1800 is 90, and then 95 will be save out debt. So we will have at the 7th standard 95. Then each standard has 100 children. 100 is like that. So by the 8th standard we have to draw with the 100. So it will be 100. And the last, or not last, 9th standard has 90 children. 90 will be here. So that 9th standard will have 90 children. And 10th standard has 80 children. So 80 will be here. So 10th standard, the bar graph will be like that. You don't need to draw this line that I, because I don't have the graph paper. In your graph paper, there will be all the lines are there, horizontal and vertical boxes. So you don't have to worry about it. You will directly be able to draw that graphs. So at last it is 80. So by this method, and if you want to decorate it, you can do like that also. Any type of design in it, so that it look that they are your graph, bar graph. You can shade it, you can make design like that, or you can do your way. So by this method, we can draw the bar graph. In the next session, we will learn how to draw the double bar graph also. But here, before we end, there are some questions also. So let's do that questions. In B, there are two questions. First, it says answer the questions. Answer the following questions. It says that which class has, number one, which class has the maximum number of children? The maximum number of children. And the minimum also. And the minimum. Now you can see that which height is the smallest? 80. And highest is 135. So we can say that standard 5th has maximum, and standard 10th has minimum number of students. There is a second question also, we can write down here. We have a space here. It says that find the ratio of students. Find the ratio of students of class 6 to the class 8. Class 6 to the class 8. So class 6 has how much? 120. So that is 120 upon. Class 8 has how many student children? 100. 120 upon 100. is equal to 6 2s are 12, 5 2s are 20, 2 cancel. So ratio is equal to 6 is to 5. That is the ratio between the class 6th to the class 8th children. So here we are going to finish today's session. Will be followed by the PDF file. And you will draw this graph in your graph book. And maybe some homework also to draw the graph. Any problem, write down in the comment section. Thank you very much.